Good morning, student. I am from Adarsh Vidya Mandir, Shankar Vidyapeeth. Student, today we are going to learn force on a current carrying conductor. In previous class, we learned about what happens when charged particle enter in the magnetic field. So, charged particle enter in the magnetic field, it experiences the force, that is F equal to Q V cross B. What happens when force on a current carrying conductor? What happens when force applied? What is the force? Which type of force when we place? Suppose a conductor we are placed in the magnetic field. Okay, conductor we are placed in the magnetic field. Then it also experience the force. Why? Because conductor is made of charge. And when current flows from the conductor, it means the electrons are moving, and electrons is also the charged particle. Then what happened? Then naturally the force is also acting on the charged particle. So first we have to find, this is our conductor PQ, which is placed in a magnetic field, and current is flowing from P to Q. Okay, here is the magnetic field B. Okay, here is the magnetic field B, and current is flowing from P to Q. Then force is act, naturally force is act by the applying our what? Fleming left hand rule, we can find the direction of the force. Just look at here, this shows the direction of the magnetic field. Index finger, middle finger shows the direction of current, or okay, and thumb shows the direction of force. Just put it here, here. Direction of the magnetic field, direction P to Q, and this one. Then force is applied in this way, okay, by using Fleming left hand rule. B is the direction of the magnetic field, I is the direction of the current, here I, this one B, and thumb show the direction of the force, okay. So force acting in this direction, but electron always moves in opposite direction of the current. So the force F, we know that force F is equal to V cross B. Okay, force F on the charge particle, here charge particle is electron. So we can then F equal to E V B. Why V D? Because electron is drifted. Then we consider either drift velocity. Electron is drifted. So we are considered V D. D is the drift velocity. And charge of electron is, charge of electron is minus E. Okay, suppose length of the conductor is L. Suppose length of the conductor is L, then there are so many charged particles inside the conductor. Okay, the number, total number of electrons. What is the total number of electrons? Consider total number of electrons. Total number of electron. Here we are consider only one electron, but the conductor is made of the so many electrons. So total number of electron, capital N, equal to number of electron into the length, that is N L. So total number of electron in a conductor is N L. Then what is the force acting? And cross section area, suppose cross section area is capital A. Cross section area of the conductor is capital A. Then force acting on the charge particle of the conductor, that is F. F equal to what? Number of electron, cross section area, and that is what? We are considered that force here by small f. Okay? Then this one. The total force F equal to N. N is the number of, N is the number of what? Number of electrons. A is the cross section area. We can also say that what? Just NF. Here is N. Okay? Total number of electrons. Capital N equal to cross section area, number of electrons. Then what? NF. Okay? Then F equal to what we get? N. What we get? N will A N L into E. That is the minus E, okay, and VB cross negative sign showed it that we are considered a charged particle to be an electron. The electron is showed that there is a charged particle having a negative. Okay, E is the negative. Now what happened? Just calculate the force. So what to do? First we have to draw some. Okay, I will do that. F equal to MEVD, where VD is the velocity, okay? V and D are perpendicular to each other, okay? We are not considering, yes, we are not considering V and V are perpendicular, okay? Suppose here the velocity VD and B, then sin theta equal to 1, then F equal to MEVD, okay? Here is MEVD, A length. Okay, L cross B. Why L cross B? Because here is the current element. Okay, we are taking as the current element. Or MEAVD. Yes. What is the value of MEAVD? In drift velocity, we find the value of current. That is MEAVD is the electron. A is the position area. VD. Then F equal to I. L cross B, okay? Then F equal to I L B sine theta. That is the force acting on a conductor having a length L. Okay, student? Just go through it again. This is conductor is made of so many electrons. That's why we are considering total number of electrons N equal to N A L. F equal to total force NF and E the electron, that's why we are putting negative charge. Okay, student? That's all for today. Thank you.